I'm Sue Crockett, the Executive Director of the Minnesota Center for Employee Ownership. At MNCEO, we serve as a resource on all forms of education about employee ownership. We want to be able to help business owners decide what's best for them when they want to exit their business. Split Rock Studios is a great example of an employee-owned company through an ESOP, an employee stock ownership plan.
We are a designer and fabricator of exhibits, and primarily permanent exhibits, so we'll work in museums all over the country, even internationally. What separates us apart from a lot of our competitors, we are that design and build firm, so we bring that whole cohesive process as a turnkey service.
I started thinking about selling the company about 7-8 years ago, and I was realizing I just didn't have the energy to run the business. We were starting to feel like we were drifting a little bit. I was trying to sell the business. The employees were wondering what's going on here. It wasn't good.
My biggest fear during those time was having a new management team come in here that had very little experience in designing and building exhibits, or coming in here and then bringing corporate strategies to try to manage the company and the employees.
The whole notion of the employees taking ownership of it and doing it in a nice formal way rather than one small group being the owners, but everyone participate in the ownership, that actually appealed to me. And then finally the ESOP opportunity sprung up and the current management team stepped up and things started to turn around, and that's where we are today.
Knowing that we were going to stay in our current location and, you know, stay with our current processes of management, I think it went over really well than kind of answering to the whims as far as someone in a different state or a corporation elsewhere.
Obviously, the benefit to the employees and their welfare was the paramount concern, and I think a third party wouldn't really have their best interest at hand. They'd have their own interest at hand.
If we didn't go the ESOP route and we had gone a third party, I can't imagine that many of us would probably still be here.
I would just say we're much more communicative as far as where we're at, because there's definitely a level of curiosity with how we're doing and how's our future look, how do we do in revenue and sales this year. So we're definitely much more transparent in the day-to-day of our internal business.
Culture is something that we've changed quite a bit since we've become employee-owned. There's a lot more employee engagement and employee participation. But as for myself, it's knowing that I have a stake in the success of this company. Being challenged to think and act as an owner by sharing new ideas, working collaboratively, and finding new ways to work more efficiently is on a level that I've never imagined.
Having that open culture, kind of that transparency, and even a lot of our employees helping each other out outside of the office. An example is, you know, lending a truck to someone that's moving, watching their pets, house sitting, just kind of that level of interaction to something we hadn't seen in prior years before we were ESOP. So I think it's definitely bolstered it, and just having that, you know, knowledge that you own the company and this impacts you has definitely made it a much more positive business culture. Whenever clients or different communities find out that we're employee owned, it definitely resonates within the community and again drives that level of intrigue. And it's something we actually put in our job ads, and it's important because I think, you know, being employee owned definitely brings a level of interest. So we definitely like to touch on that and take advantage of it, but again, it's something that's completely free to the employees, so it's a nice perk to be able to help sell to new employees.
Frankly, when I did it, I wasn't aware of an organization that could have helped us out, and I'm glad to hear there is one. The Minnesota Center for Employee Ownership is a group that I think could definitely help out. A nonprofit has some of the same philosophies as the ESOP organizations do, and it would have been a good resource for me. I felt I was doing it alone, and it would have been better to have an advocate that was not necessarily interested in any particular group, but was interested in everybody.
I'm happy that Split Rock Studios was able to share their employee-owned story. And we have many more stories that we can share with business owners that are personal and show the benefits of employee ownership. If you are thinking about what you want to do in the future when you exit your business, please contact me at MNCEO, and we will be able to help you with educational pieces and with resources to professionals to make the journey easier for you.